admit na po our press. Hi everyone, good afternoon po. Thank you for joining us this afternoon for this momentous event. Today, Kapuso Global Endorser and IRL host Gabbi Garcia marked another milestone in her career as she renewed her contract with GMA Artist Center. All right, without further ado, here to celebrate with us, let us all welcome Ms. Gabbi Garcia.
Hello po everyone. Hello po sa ating friends from the press. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you for making time. And I miss everyone. I miss press cons. So I'm looking forward for this one.
Thank you, Gabbi. Before we begin po with the Q&A, I would like to acknowledge the presence of Assistant Vice President for Corporate Communication, Mr. Jojo Akio. Hi, sir. Good afternoon po.
Afternoon.
Hi, sir.
All right. Let us proceed na po to the interview. Our first set of questions will be coming from Nikki Wang of Manila Standard. Hi, Nikki. Good afternoon.
Hi, Carla. Thank you. Hi, Gabbi.
Hi, sir. Nikki. Nice to see you again.
Well, the pleasure is mine, Gabbi. You know, congratulations for renewing your contract with GMA. Tama ba? It's 6 years ka na with a GMA?
You know what, Sir Nikki? Almost 8 na. Actually, 7. Kasi I started 2014. Pati ako, I lost count na rin eh. I started 2014. So, 2021. 7 years. Almost 8 na this February next
year. Yes, nakita ko kayo na 2014 nga. So, akala ko sa 2020 pa rin tayo. But anyway. in yours, almost... 7 years?
8 years.
Eight years in GMA. Which among your projects do you consider as the defining moment of your career?
Oh, that definitely ano pa din talaga, Sir Nikki and Kanbadia. Mm-hmm. It literally changed my life 180 degrees. Talagang it gave me the biggest break. It gave me the biggest opportunity. And it also served as self-fulfillment for me. Doing that show.
It's nice to know. And of course, speaking of your projects with GMA, this Saturday, mag-i-air na yung Your Regal Present episode.
Yes, right? Yes, yes. That's right, Sir Nikki. This Saturday na.
Pero how does it feel doing this project with Khalil?
Really, really good. It's our first TV appearance together. So, mas exciting siya. And also, it's nice that Regal and GMA are collaborating with this kind of project. No, it gives a lot more opportunities to the artists of GMA. At the same time, diba, dagdag good vibes every weekend. So, yun. I'm excited for this show to air, yung episode namin ni Khalil, because it's just really light. It's very, it's a rom-com. And, diba, sa panahon ngayon, it's so important to feel light and to, you know, cheer up ourselves. So, pati ako, I'm looking forward to see the whole episode this Saturday.
Nasabi mo, the episode is light because it's rom-com. Pero, behind the scenes, off cam, anong dynamics ni Khalil while on set?
Well, at first kasi, when we were doing our movie before for Pista ng Pelikulang Pilipina, doon talaga medyo nagkakapaan kami on our work ethics. But after that, kasi a lot of opportunities came in and us working together. So this one was kind of a breeze for the both of us. It was a lot easier. When it comes to our work ethics, kasi we always tell ourselves that we are actors first when we are on the set. And we are not, you know, kumbaga secondary na yung, okay, we're in a relationship or we're partners. But being an actor comes first. So, yun, we help each other. Kalil is very generous when it comes to acting. He really talks to me. He discusses with me the obligations of the character, the character mismo and the story. So, it's a give and take kind of work ethic for the both of us.
Right. And of course, new contract with GMA. Since bagong partnership mo sa yung mother studio, for your next projects, sino yung gusto mong makasama? And what kind of genre would you like to be your next probably movie or next TV project would be?
Well, I have, diba, ang dami nating dream artists na makakatrabaho. Mm-hmm. But you know what, ako, anybody talaga that they would give me to work with, I'm game naman. But siguro if you would ask me whom I really want to work with, siguro I really want to work with Kuya Dong. I always see Kuya Dong, you know, sa guest things again, but I haven't really like worked with him like in a show or a film. And in the future, I really want to do more films. Mm-mm. I want to explore my versatility as an actress sa film, sa pelikula, kasi it's different shooting a film. Eh. You need to have a lot of patience. You need to really, really like study and, you know, own the character. And future dream roles. I really want to do a GL series, Sir Nikki. Yeah. I really want to do a GL series. I want to challenge myself at the same time because I'm an ally. So I wanna do that. And siguro more action pa.
Mm. So GL and action are the genres that you would like to do in the future.
Mm-hmm. And siguro, ano, I'm also game to do like a film that is like, ano, coming of age film. Ganon.
Well, since nabanggit mo yung GL, sino na lang yung gusto mo makasama in just in case you're going to have a project like that?
In GMA?
Yes.
I sabi ko nga eh, parang feeling ko it's fun to work with Sanya when it comes to like a GL.
Sabagay si Sanya, gusto rin magkaroon ng GL eh.
Ah, really? Yeah. Ito, talaga? Ayun. Ayun. Ayun, parang ano, parang nakikita ko din yun. Parang very possible because Sani and I are close and we work together na. So I feel like there's gonna be a good dynamic there.
But anyway, thank you for generously answering my questions, Gabby. And again, congratulations with renewal of contract with GMA. Thank you.
Thank you, Nikki. The next set of questions naman po will be coming from Tito Jun Nardo. Hi, Tito. Good afternoon po.
Tita June, kamusta ka na?
Good afternoon. Congratulations. Ito, ikaw, maganda pa rin.
Siyempre, Tito June.
In love pa rin. Kahit na sa ilang taon mo sa GMA, anong pinakamagandang nangyari sa'yo? Anong pinakamagandang nangyari sa karir mo at sa buhay mo sa GMA?
Ang dami, Tito June. Siguro yung number one na pinakamagandang nangyari sa akin sa GMA is isa silang instrument sa pagtupad ng mga pangarap ko from the get-go. In representing different brands in Encantadia, tapos I got to play different roles. Siguro in general talaga, GMA was the instrument. God gave me GMA para maging magsilbing daan to reach my dreams, and I'm always grateful for that po.
Wow, grabe naman. Kailan kaya namin makikita ka na nasa isang dramatic TV appearance, drama. Magaling ka ba magdrama? Magaling ka ba umiyak, Gabby?
Ayoko sumagot niyan, Tito June. Tanong natin yung management. Pero ano, pero kung bibigyan nila ako, Tito June, why not? Game naman ako dyan. Game ako sa ultimate drama roles na ganyan.
Nung nabanggit ni Khalil na natorpe daw sa sayo minsan, especially torpe, Torpin yung role niya dito sa Regal Studio, di ba?
How yes. was it? Yes, Tito June. Ano, well, si Khalil kasi he's an introvert. Eh ako, di ba, Tito June, kilala mo naman ako, very extrovert yes. ako, very madaldal ako and all. So, very opposite kami ni Khalil. Kaya nung una, talagang hiyang-hiya siya. Nahihiya siyang makipag-usap. Actually, until now naman, sa mga iba naming nakakasama, ganun pa rin siya. Hindi naman sa ayaw niya magsalita, pero talagang lumalabas yung pagka-introvert niya.
Ayun.
Oo, very siya.
Ano, meron type ba yun? Ano ba? Pwede ba?
Very ano siya, Tito Ju, very misteryoso kasi siya.
Oo, nagustuhan mo yun.
Oo, 'di ba? Hindi agad-agad all out. Medyo parang parang kailangan mag-spend tayo ng more time together para makilala kita lalo, 'di ba? May pagganon.
May pagganon ba? Ano? Marrying type ba siya? Marrying kind?
Marrying Tito June?
Yes.
Well, Tita June, kasi diba, wala namang, kumbaga, there's no point naman in getting into a relationship kung hindi naman yun yung target mo. So I guess as of now, of course, oo, pero matagal pa yun, Tita June. Dami ko pa kailangan, kakarenew ko lang.
No, alam ko.
Hindi pwede.
Matagal pa, good luck, Gabby.
Thank you po, Tita June.
See you around. Ingat.
Thank you po.
Thank you, Tito June. Before we proceed to the next set of questions, I'd like to acknowledge again the presence of Vice President for Corporate Affairs and Communications, Ms. Angel Javier Cruz. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon. Congratulations, Gabby.
Hi, Ms. Angel. Thank you po.
Andod ako kanina sa signing. Di na lang ako nakigreet kasi ang dami nagigreet ngayon na lang.
Okay. Thank you po, Ms. Angel. Thank you.
Hello, dear friends from the press also. Ganda-ganda ni Gabby. As usual. Miss you all.
Yes. Miss you, Miss Angel.
Thank you, ma'am. The next set of questions po will be coming from Alan Policarpio of Philippine Daily Inquirer. Hi, Alan. Hi. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Hi, Gabby. Congratulations.
Hi, sister Alan. Thank you. Nice to see you again.
Again.
Last lang ata yun, ano?
It's illegal. Yes.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's nice to see you back again sa acting, doing television work. Pero before, ditong nakaraang araw because of the pandemic, what have you been focusing on outside acting naman? I mean, yung pinagkakabalaan.
Outside acting? Yes. You know what? Kasi diba, the past year has been such a struggle for all of us, you know. Kanya-kanya naman tayo ng version ng struggles natin. And for me, being productive at home helped a lot. So during my spare time, nung lockdown, we started the podcast called Figure It Out on Spotify and on YouTube, and also a food show called Front Seat Foodies on YouTube. So we've been very busy producing and creating content together. Yon, talagang, we have fun eh. We have so much fun kasi two-man team lang kami. Khalil has his own production house kasi, kaya we have equipment, and then para lang kami naglalaro actually, Sir Alan. Pero, you know, it's out of productivity and out of creativity. Kaya maganda yung bunga.
Pero as a celebrity in this parang digital age, do you think it's important for you guys na to be able to do everything, or to be not just limited to acting or to doing TV work?
Well, of course, it's always nice to be a well-rounded artist and a well-rounded person also. Every day we keep on learning, we keep on learning new skills. And for me, kasi I'm challenged by the current times. We are all challenged kasi, diba, may social media na, may TV na. So, you know, it serves as a challenge for myself na I have to be a versatile and a well-rounded artist. And you know, it doesn't mean naman na yung ibang nag-focus sa acting hindi nakasama sa trend, 'di ba? Kanya-kanya naman tayo. It's just ako mismo, I really want to be a well-rounded artist so that work doesn't stop. And you know, I can reach lots of people, I can reach lots of audience para ayun, they get to relate with me also.
And I know you also have parang a lot of endorsements, and you do influencer world as well.
Mm-hmm.
Pero hindi naman ba siya parang nagka-clash sa acting side? Parang hindi ka naman nalilimitahan because, you know, you have these commitments here. So parang ganito lang yung pwedeng roles na gawin mo. Wala namang ganun.
You know what? That's why GMA is there, I guess, Sir Alan. Kasi sila talaga yung nagmamanage. They're the ones who weigh things. Sila yung nag-weigh kung worth it ba kunin to in exchange of this one, you know. That's why I'm grateful for them. Kasi talagang without them, I wouldn't be able to weigh things and I wouldn't be able to balance the blessings in my career. Kasi diba, you can't have everything naman also. So they're the ones who are helping me to manage everything.
I know a lot of people then have been bugging you about joining pageants. And, you know, so anong feelings mo about that? Has that changed?
You know what? The dream is really there. Ever since I was a kid talaga, I've been very vocal about it also sa interviews that the dream has always been there. I'm just waiting for the right time. Meaning the right time siguro when the time comes that I'm 200% focused on pageantry. The time wherein I have my full attention and my full commitment to pageantry. As of now, kasi there are a lot in my plate. Hirap kasi ng hatiin yung sarili mo eh, you know, I don't wanna enter pageantry ng hilaw pa ako. Gusto ko, like, I'm really ready and I'm 100% committed. And when the time comes, game, di ba? I'm the dream is there anyway, the desire is there, so why not?
It's good na rin siguro na these days na parang yung mga pageant, parang they're also changing, hindi na lang siya para sa mga teenagers or mga young. Parang you can still join at a later stage in your life and more well-rounded.
It's becoming more diverse now.
Okay. Thanks, Gabbi.
Thank you.
Congrats again.
Thank you po.
Thank you, Alan. The next set of questions naman po will be coming from Jerry Donato of Philippine Star. Hi, Jerry.
Hi, Carla. Hi, Gabbi.
Hi, good afternoon. Hello.
Yes, hi. Kasi usually naman, di ba, kapag nagsasign ng contract yung isang artista, I think it's also a perfect time to reflect on what you have or to look back on of what you have achieved in your career. Meron ka rin bang ganong parang moment when you know, do that renewing your contract? Nakakapag, do you have enough time or space para mag-reflect din kung ano pa yung mga gusto mong gawin? And if you do, ano yung mga, what are the thoughts that's, ano, there in your mind?
Yes, of course. There are a lot of thinking, a lot of realizations, a lot of muni-muni, di ba? Kapag, you know, especially now that I'm almost 8 years with GMA. Mm. And actually, a few weeks ago, they showed me one AVP wherein, yun nga, pinapakita yung milestones every year. Ano yung mga, and yun yung parang moments na mapapa-sit back ka. And, you know, you take a step back and you realize na, wow, you've done so much, but yet you have so much more to achieve. And I think I'm in that state wherein I am still hungry up to this point. I am still looking forward to whatever I can achieve. And I'm just so grateful. Really, really grateful. Kasi I do not have any connections in show business. My family's private, you know. I'm the only artista in the family. So I really started from the bottom. Like, literally, I fell in line. I auditioned, then VTR ako and GMA, and they got me. So, like, from step one up to now, talagang I can really say that I'm proud and I'm grateful to wherever I am right now.
Tapos kasi curious lang ako, when you entered showbiz, how did you, I mean, perceive, no, yung career na magkakaroon ka? As an actress ba, singer, or just, you know, a well-rounded performer? Kasi 2 years na lang, then isang dekada ka na, so dapat meron din mga bagong pinaplano.
Yes. Well, when I entered kasi, actually, hindi ko kasi in-expect na makakapasok ako. So like, yung utak ko that time was just really, wala, let's just enter and let's try my luck. And I was just 15 that time kasi. So I didn't really have, like concrete plans in my head. And I feel like dun pumasok si GMA into honing the skills I have, into, you know, redirecting my mindset na, oh, you can be good at this pala, you can be good at that. So yun. But as of now, I'm in the stage where I really want to hone my skills. Diba? Ito yung parang stage na, yes, I'm a well-rounded artist, but this time I want to focus on each of my skills and I want to hone it.
Kumbaga, dapat equally distributed yung oras and then, of course, the projects that you will be embarking on each skill that you have. But for my last question na lang, sa palagay mo, bakit naging, aside from having a very supportive network that is very concerned about you and your growth, but on a personal level, what do you think are the key factors why your career is a success or why you have a success story as an artist?
I'm a very straightforward person. I'm a very eager person. Like, buong buo yung eagerness sa loob ko to be an achiever. Ever since I was in grade school, in high school, I'm more of a leader. I was a student council when I was a kid. Ako yung classmate mong bibo-bibo sa Christmas party. Okay. That's my personality. Yeah. So I feel like I applied everything ngayong nasa showbiz na ako. Is that I'm 100% gigil. And I just don't let anybody dictate what my career path will be. I also contribute. I also work hand in hand with the team. And I make sure that everything will fall into place. So I feel like the right dedication and eagerness talaga will bring you to the right place.
Thank you, Gabbi, for answering my questions.
Thank you.
God bless.
Thank you, Jerry. The next set of questions po will be coming from Sir Richard Paglikawan of Lionheart TV. Hi, sir. Good afternoon.
Hello, Gabbi. Good afternoon.
Thank you so much.
Ayun. So, maraming mga celebrities yung laging naghahanap, yung gustong ma-challenge lagi. Parang every year, parang naghahanap sila ng challenging sa career nila. And as an actor, ikaw pa, Gabbi, in 7 years of doing projects in GMA, ano sa palagay mo yung pinaka-challenging na nagawa mo? And in the future, if ever tatanungin ka ng management kung anong project yung magpupush pa sa'yo as an actor, ano yun at bakit?
The most challenging muna that I've done in the network, siguro ito more on a more personal level, was to go on my own. Kasi I started with a love team po. So, the most challenging was to do projects alone. Without a love team. And that started in Pamilya Roses. So, yung time na yon up to now, that was a chunk of challenge for me to stand on my own. And to, you know, prove myself that I can also do it by myself. With the help of the network. And then more challenging pa po na gusto kong i-face with the network. Yun nga, I really wanna try a GL series. So for me, that's really challenging. And it sends out a good message as well. And I want to challenge myself also to be a better actress. And maybe soon, you know, do a film that will go international. Yung mga ganon. It's a continuous learning kasi. And I wanna challenge myself to learn every day, every year.
And speaking of challenge, kasi related to dun sa episode nyo ni Khalil sa Regal Studio Presents, if ever mapupush ka to do something great, syempre hindi na yung pagjojowa kasi meron ka na. Ano yun at bakit?
To do something great?
Oh, for 1 million comments, parang ganun.
Oh, okay. 1 million comments to do something great? 1 million comments, sasali na ako next year sa Miss Universe. Uy, pero wag muna. Ayun po.
So, kasi di ba nakita namin ikaw na parang as at an early stage talaga may mga ano ba, nakita ka na namin na may mga ano ba yung mga sinasalihan mo before para mga workshops,
Uh-uh.
Ang ganun, modeling, ganyan.
Yeah.
So, at an early stage, yun ba talaga yung ano, na-realize mo na pang showbiz ka talaga?
Siguro kasi, I didn't know that the term na showbiz pala yung gusto kong pasukan. Pero ever since kasi I gave hints na to my family that I love performing, na hindi ako mahiyain, makapal mukha ko when it comes to like mga gathering, mga ganun. So I feel like it was innate na. Na I didn't even have to pinpoint na gusto ko maging artista kasi talagang it naturally shows when I was a kid. So when I finally became a teenager, dun ko na-realize na showbiz pala yung venue for this kind of desire. So yun, lately ko na lang siya ni-realize na showbiz pala ako belong.
Pero ano yung one thing na from your parang childhood experiences na hanggang ngayon dala-dala mo, na parang pinanghahawakan mo na ito talaga yun?
Childhood experiences na pinanghahawakan ko, siguro nung times na pumipila ako sa mga VTRs and I get rejected. A lot of times, a bunch of times. I always go to VTRs kasi and to auditions. Kahit ano, commercials, talent search, yung mga maliliit na beauty contest, I always line up. So yun yung pinanghawakan ko ngayon na whenever I have struggles or you know, whenever I'm doubting myself, I always look back na, oops, dati ganito lang, ngayon nandito ka na. So yun.
Thank you, Gabbi, and congratulations.
Thank you, Bot. Thank you.
Thank you, Sir Richard. Ang susunod naman po na magtatanong ay si Tito Gorgie Rula. Hi, Tito Gorgie.
Hi, Tito Gorgie.
Hello. Tika lang, ha. Hi, congratulations.
Hi, Tito Gorgie. Thank you, Bot.
Saan ba ako magsisimula? Parang ang dami kong tatanong sa'yo. And then, dun muna sa episode mo sa Regal, yung comments. So far in your, ilan ka? Mag-8 years ka na ba sa showbiz? Sa dami, active ka rin sa social media, sa mga million-million comments na natatanggap mo, anong hindi mo makakalimutan? Na iniyakan mo, nasaktan ka, anong hindi mo makakalimutan na comment?
Pwede bang mga 10, Char?
Adami.
pinaka hindi ko makakalimutan. Siguro yung time na... Naku, hindi ko alam kung saan ako mamimili. Yung time kasi, Tito Gordy, na sunod-sunod yung balita sa akin. Kasi the time na bago pa lang ako sa showbiz and I was still adjusting. Tapos batang-bata pa ako, I was 15. Dami kasing lumalabas na... Maarte ako, mahirap pakisamahan, yung mga before pa na mga sinasabi tungkol sa akin. Yun talaga yung I was so frustrated na parang bakit ba ganito, hindi ba to para sa akin? But you know what, looking back, I can just see a little girl being lost. Na ngayon natatawanan ko na lang na bakit talaga kasi it was a learning process for me. Pero that time, grabe yung iyak ko noon.
At may natutunan ka doon, di ba? So sa dami rin siguro sa mga bashing din na natanggap mo, nagbago ka rin, kumbaga sa ano, that made you parang stronger ba? Or parang wiser? Or masasabi natin?
Yeah, siguro the right word for that is I grew up. I grew up talaga. From that little girl na nagulat sa showbiz na ganito pala dito. Tapos lumipas yung mga taon. I grew up and nag-mature. Learned a lot of life lessons and then ayun na. Okay na ulit.
Disorient ka kung bago pa lang, no?
Yes, na culture shock talaga ako, Tito Gorgie, kasi when I entered, I was just 15. Very sheltered ako, Tito Gorgie, na I wasn't so exposed to the real world. Ang alam ko lang pasok sa school, co-curricular activities ako sa school, uwi ako and then yun na yung routine ko. So, di ako masyadong na-expose na, ay, ganito pala yung mundo. So, really had to learn the hard way.
Mm-hmm. So, itong nagpirma ka ng renewal, pang third mo na ba to na renewal? Or second? Third?
Third
mo na as Kapuso exclusive artist. Anong feeling mo na, ay, pangatlong kontrata ko na to? Tapos sa gitna ng medyo, well, pandemic pa, Plus, may mga iba na, na ano pa, napapalipat pa sa ibang istasyon. Ikaw ba? Ikaw ba na ano, na meron bang mga nagparinig sa'yo before or nagparamdam sa'yo? At anong, alam, well, ramdam naman namin na hindi mo iiwan ang GMA. Nandun naman talaga na hirap na iiwan. At naalaga ka naman ng gusto. Pero, may mga ganun bang instance na na-allow ka rin or na-offer ka rin na parinigang na...
Naalala mo, Tito Gorgie, yung ano, yung panahon na ang ingay-ingay, nanilipat daw ako. Yung ang daming write-ups.
Isa ka dun sa napasama sa...
Oo! Pati ako, takang-taka ako, bakit ako nandun? Kaya parang, siguro nung time na yon, Tito Gorgie, may mga naririnig-rinig po talaga ako. Pero, ano lang po, po?
Walang may nag-offer naman talaga.
Parang ano lang, informal eh. Hindi okay. Siya formal eh. Be, ano lang, lagi lang na...
Mm-hmm.
Kasi that time, kasi Tito Gorgie, yun yung mga times na sumasama ako sa friends ko from ABS.
Yes, may nag-friends na kasi doon.
Yes, ang dami ko kasing friends doon. So, often exposed tuloy ako sa kabilang network. Mm-hmm. Which is for me naman, it's just really pure friendship. Wala naman akong habol doon kasi I'm really contented and I'm happy where I'm at. Pero yun lang, very mga informal offers na ganun. Mga sabi-sabi. Oh, and ano naman, GMA knows that naman. I've been very honest with them.
Mm-hmm. Parang isa ka pa nga yata dati sa na-chismis na nag-audition ba sa Darna? Sabi talaga, parang ganun.
Ay, hindi ako yon, Tito Gorgie.
O sige, sino yon? Okay. O sige. Okay. Di ba, ano na lang kasi nga, ito na nga kay Khalil. Sayang kasi ang ganda ng paglipat nga sana ni Khalil. Tapos last year, pre-pandemic pa yata, yung yes. Na-announce yung...
Ay, October last year, Tito Gorgie.
Hindi, yung na-announce yung ano ninyo, yung drama series, yung gagawin yung series, yung Love You Stranger. Pandemic. Yes. Ganun.
Mm. Opo, lumipat si Khalil October, in-announce yun December, last year.
December, tapos eto na mag-one year, hindi pa rin natuloy-tuloy, parang nakaka-frustrate kasi parang ang daming problemang hinarap. Tapos yes. Ang latest yata, January na raw kayo mag-resume. So paano yung pinag-usapan ni Khalil yun at anong, how does it feel?
Of course, Tito Gorgie, hindi naman ako magsisinungaling na okay lang, di ba? Of course, I felt I was also sad, di ba? Frustrated. Pero more on, I'm just really trying to understand the whole situation. Kasi Tito Gorgie, kahit, naging honest naman sila sa amin when it comes to the show, na ito yung mga naging problema, kinausap kami, sinit down kami, which I really appreciate, and they really explained to us what happened. And more than anything, it's more of understanding talaga. I understood them, where they're coming from, and they also respected how we felt. But at the end of the day, diba, Tito Gorgie, kasi isa naman kaming team dyan sa GMA eh. So, nothing naman will happen if magdadamdam tayo sa isa. And the important thing is, matutuloy pa rin talaga the show next year. And kahit na hindi pa natutuloy yung show, is they gave us other shows, which is ngayon, Tito Gorgie, this October, malalock in kami ni Khalil for Stories from the Heart.
Oh.
It's a mini-series. Iyon yung ginagawa nila Kelvin and Dimas Beauty ngayon.
Yes.
So kami yung pangatlo ata, pangatlong episode, ay pangatlong ano ata kami series. Yes, oo. It will be shown on November ata or December if I'm not mistaken, but definitely may ilalabas kami this last quarter.
So we can say talaga na tuloy yung Love You Stranger.
Yes, as in like it is gonna push through. Hindi pwedeng hindi dahil ang ganda-ganda ng storya. Sayang naman.
Oo. And pakisabi na rin kay Khalil, sorry nung last press con kasi sa Regal, akala ko kasama siya dun sa umalis ka nung press con na paaga ka ano. Hindi ko nasabi sa kanya na napakagaling niya sa rest back. Napanood ko yung kay Direk Brillante Mendoza.
Paano niya napanood? Saan?
And na-invite kami ni Direk Brillante na panuurin yung rest back na isasali yata sa isang international film fest.
Yeah, sa Tokyo ata.
Sa Tokyo, if I'm not mistaken. So, ang galing niya doon na... magaling din siya doon dati sa Honor Thy Father ba yun?
Yes.
Okay. So, na-mention before ni Khalil na may mga iba rin siyang plans. Like, isa yata sa gusto rin niya ay parang mag-direct. mag-direct ng isang film project o ano man. Napapag-usapan din niyo yan? May mga collab ba kayo na project na pwede ninyong pagsamahan?
Collab? Na siya magdidirect, Tito Gordy?
Pwede, oo. Or kung ikaw ang artista or ano man. Wala ba kayo napapag-usapang project na matuloy yung iba pa niyang plans or iba pa niyang dreams?
Well, Tito Gorgie, nag-start kami actually mag-date noong 2017 na siya yung director ko sa music video ko for my self-produced song. And then lately, ngayon, nagko-collab kami when it comes to podcasting. May podcast kami and also the food show. So siya yung mainly in charge sa technical, sa camera, sa pagdidirect. But you know, Tito Gorgie, given a chance na maging director, like film director talaga siya, siguro dun muna siya sa mga iba niyang pangarap na katrabaho na artista. Sa last part, support system muna ako kasi parang feeling ko medyo awkward kapag ako yung una niyang artista. Pero yun, full support naman ako dito, Gordy, kahit sa anong gusto niyang gawin. And saka mahusay talaga siyang aktor. Napanood ko dun yung Tukul to be Forgotten niya. Grabe. Nung una ko siyang nakasama sa eksena, merong kaba eh. Ako mismo, may kaba ako kasi ang galing-galing niyang aktor. Pero very generous. Very generous siya sa eksena. Tsaka, malalim na aktor.
Okay. Yung nabanggit mo kanina yung GL series, tapos may na-mention ka, Sanya Lopez, gaano ka bigay dito kung sakaling mabigyan ka ng GL series? Open ka sa kissing scene with may mga limitations ba o hanggang saan?
Ay, Tito Gorgy, kung anong nire-require ng script, game naman ako dyan. And tignan na lang natin kung game din si Artist Center. If game din sila, diba, why not? Tsaka, I've always been an ally, a proud supporter. So, okay naman po ako.
So, open ka doon sa kung ano man ang pwede para ma-challenge ka na gusto talaga sa project. Yung mga hindi mo pa, yung parang out of the box talaga na.
Yes, open po ako.
Nung nag-sign ka dito ngayon, nung huling ng renewal mo, ano ang mga na-pinramise na naka-line up sa'yo?
Ito nga po, yung Stories from the Heart, ilalagay na po ako agad. And then, Love You Stranger. And then, next year po, meron din po akong gagawin abroad na hindi ko pa po pwedeng sabihin. Pero that is after Love You Stranger naman. And continuous lang po ako sa All Out Sunday, sa variety show, para ma-showcase din yung performing skills. And then yun lang, Tito Gorgie. So far, medyo buo na agad yung taon ko next year. Kaya very, very grateful and excited po.
Okay. Sige. Good luck and congratulations.
Thank you po.
Thank you, Tito Gorgie. Ang susunod naman po na magtatanong ay si Tito Mario Bautista. Tito Mario, hello po.
Tito Mario.
Hello.
Hi, Tito Mario. Ayan. Hello.
Gabby, I still remember when we first met you sa Destiny Rose. You were just a teeny bopper, 15 years old. And now, ang layo na nang itinakbo ng career mo.
Opo.
And all throughout, we know that you have always planned to join a beauty pageant. So, right now, I don't think you can join kasi sa dami ng ginagawa mo, di ba?
Yes, opo, totoo.
Pero nakakapanghinayang kasi yung Morena beauty mo, you're being very intelligent and very articulate, talagang pang beauty pa dyan. So anong balak mong gawin to help you nurture all these talents of yours that will be a big help to you when you join a pageant?
Tito Mario, you know what, when the right time comes na I'm able to join, I will allot a year, at least a year to prepare for it. I'm open in doing trainings, speech communication, and walk, workout, lahat, Tito Mario. I'm really, really game and I'm up for the challenge to prepare for it. Kaya po talagang, for example, na-feel ko na that this is the right time. I will make time to train before I enter.
Naku, kailan ba kaya yun? Dapat siguro i-plan mo within the next 2 or 3 years. Kasi 22 ka na ngayon, right?
Oh, yes, sorry.
I think before, bago ka mag-25, mag-join ka na ng pageant. That's the best time for you. And I hope, yun nga, you can take time out. Parang ang hirap gawin sa dami ng ginagawa mo, no? But wishing you the best of luck. So now, thank ang you. Gusto ko na lang pag-usapan, bakit ang title ng episode niyo sa Regal is 1 million comments, magjojowa na ako? Who said that line in the story?
Ako, yung character ko, Tito Mario.
Oh, so what is the your character? Tell us about it.
Kasi Tito Mario, di ba meron ngayong mga usong-uso na 1 million comments, mag-aaral na ako, or 1 million comments, blah, blah, blah. In my case, it's for my character kasi ang tagal na niyang walang jowa. And she also has a housemate, a cousin na played by Kat Galang, na pinupush siya na, girl, kailangan mo na ng love life. So it was an April Fool's Day post. So kumbaga, for my character, it's only a prank. Eh kaso, naka 1 million comments nga talaga. So, doon iikot yung story, Tito Mario, kung talaga bang susundin ko yung 1 million comments, magjojowa na ako, or mag-ano ako, magtutuparin ko pa yung pangarap ko.
Eh, saan pumasok si Khalil, yung character niya?
So, si Khalil naman, ano siya, IT siya. Nagtrabaho siya for IT. So, siya yung nag-aayos ng mga computers, ng mga software, wifi, ganyan. Eh, since nga, ano ako, work from home ako, Tito Mario, online shooter ako. So, kailangan laging set yung computer ko. So, eh, one time nasiraan ako. So, siya yung dumating. And then, yun na.
But akala ko meron parang love triangle daw kayo dito, sabi nung ni Khalil dun sa first press con.
Yes, Tito Mario, si Manolo. Yung
Manolo
Pedrosa.
Ah!
Eh, yun. So,
siya
yung magiging had lang. Basta merong twist sa character niya. Yung twist ay nasa character niya. Magkakaalaman, kumbaga, dahil sa character niya.
So he's the third wheel in the story.
Yes, yes. Opo.
Well, it sounds very exciting. Sana mag-rate din na kagaya nung the first two episodes ni na Sanya and then ni na Sofia Pablo. Kayo ang third din, no?
Yes po, yes po.
So, I'm very excited for you para pati doon sa international project na gagawin mo. I wish you all the best sa bagong contract mo sa GMA. Good luck and God bless.
Thank you po, Tito Mario. Salamat.
Thank you po, Tito Mario. The next set of questions po will be coming from Tom Pornell of Pika Pika. Hi, Tom.
Hello po. Good afternoon. Hi, Gabby.
Hi, Tom.
Hello. Congratulations sa bago mong contract with GMA.
Thank you.
Ang galing naman.
Thank you.
Okay. Curious lang ako sa dami ng pinagdaanan mo. No, bago ka nakapasok at naabot yung estado mo ngayon, pumasok ba sa isip mo before na sumuko na lang? Kasi parang sabi mo before, ang dami mong rejection na natanggap. May ganun ka bang naisip before?
Yes, definitely. Meron talaga. Kasi, kwento ko lang, when I was younger, I started auditioning when I was 4 years old. So, pangarap ko yan before to be out there at a very young age. But then, yun nga, nung bata kasi ako, iba yung definition ng society sa maganda. Eh, dun time na yun, chubby ako na morenang-morena ako, na Pinoy na Pinay na Pinay. So, medyo I wasn't that lucky to be able to land something. So, daming rejections talaga. But then, cut to, nagkaroon na naman ako ng opportunity when I was around 12 years old. Tapos na-reject ulit ako. So, after that, ayoko na. Tigil na talaga. Like, hindi na talaga. Maybe this isn't for me. Baka iba yung path para sa akin. Tsaka, nag-focus ako sa studies ko kasi I wanted to be a pilot that time. So, talagang, yun yung dedication na talaga for being a pilot. Tapos, come 2014, when I was 15, doon dumating yung opportunity nung GMA, in which nagulat ako na everything ran smoothly. Na sinabihan lang ako na punta ka sa GMA building, present ka ng kanta ka isang song, ready ka ng isang monologue, and then after a week, I got a call back. And then after a week, nakaharap ko na sila Miss Annette, sila Tito Joey. And then after a week, hello, ito ba si Gabriela Lopez? Kasi ipirma ka na ng kontrata. So parang ako, parang, grabe, ang bilis, parang meant to be. So in an instant talaga, nag-go na ako because, diba, after how many years of dreaming, finally, ito na. So GMA gave me the opportunity talaga. They opened the doors for me.
And it's a good thing na kahit ang daming rejections, hindi ka sumuko, di ba?
Yes, feeling ko kasi nasa ano talaga, nasa personality ko siya. I'm a very strong and palaban kind of person. I don't easily give up kasi. If I give up, ibig sabihin talagang, ano talaga, hindi na talaga kaya. But ayun, so feeling ko it helped me also my values in trusting God and trusting the process.
Okay, that's great. And nasabi mo kanina yung about sa insecurities, no? So ngayong marami ka na na-achieve sa showbiz, marami ka na napatunayan, masasabi mo ba na somehow na-overcome mo na yung pagiging insecure mo sa yung pagiging morena? Kasi di ba parang mostly sa showbiz natin, kadalasan nakaka-penetrate talaga yung mga mestiza, yung mga, kumbaga yung mga mixed blood. Pero ikaw, as a Filipina, as a morena, you're able to to penetrate showbiz. So ngayon ba na-overcome na yung pagiging yung insecure mo sa with your skin?
Yes, very much. I even love and I'm proud of my skin. Lalo na ngayon, the industry is starting to be more diverse. Nakikita ko kahit sa pageants, diba? Kumbaga, mas open na ang mundo ngayon, which I'm so proud of. And I'm also happy that I'm able to contribute. I'm able to represent all the young girls who are insecure, who are having troubles accepting their flaws and their skin color. I'm able to, you know, represent them on TV and on social media. Kasi for me, kasi representation is so important. Growing up kasi, di ba, papanoorin mo yung mga morena din nung araw, like sila Miss Judy Ann, di ba, papanoorin mo na lang, pwede pala yung ganun. Kumbaga may chance pala ako sa industry. So, like me, I'm able also to inspire other girls na pwede, kahit na, di ba, it's not all about your skin complexion.
Okay, thank you. And for my last question na lang, sinabi mo kanina na talagang yung Encantadia was the defining moment ng career mo sa showbiz. And hanggang ngayon may clamor pa rin for you to have season 2. So ano namang masasabi mo doon na hanggang ngayon parang ang taas at ang lakas pa rin ng fan base ng show?
Totoo yan. Grabe. Alam mo, grabe talaga yung nabuong fanbase ng show. Actually, mas more on fanbase sila ng show kaysa sa fanbase sila ng artista. Mm-hmm. Talaga yung show yung sinusuportahan nila. And I'm very, very grateful to be part of that show. To be part of the Four Sangres. And for season 2, why not? I'm full support. Isang tawag lang. Game ako to do it anytime. And let's hope for the best. Kasi kahit naman kami, whenever we talk about it, whenever we see each other, kami nila, Liza, nila, yung mga apat na sangre, whenever we talk about na sana magkaroon ng season 2, we're all game for it. So, let's pray, let's hope for the best.
Sige, sana. Ipagdasal natin yan.
True!
Okay. Congratulations, Gabby. That's all from me. Congratulations.
Thank you, Tom. The next question naman po ay galing kay Tito Eugene Assis of People's Journal. Ito po yung question niya. Gabby, when you said more challenging roles, does that mean you are willing to go more daring?
More daring? Like sexy roles? Yeah. Siguro as of now, kasi I'm still stretching my opportunities. Siguro I'm still trying to reserve that part when I grow older pa. So, para meron pa tayong bala when it comes, when I get older. So, siguro more mature roles. But daring roles, siguro, I would reserve that for the future years pa.
Alright. The next question naman is from Sir Neil Ramos of Tempo. How does it feel being built up as the next big Kapuso star?
Very, very grateful, very humbling. And talagang it only shows that GMA has always been by my side ever since, from the start pa lang talaga. They have been so supportive and I'm just really, really grateful and excited ako sa kung ano man yung in store for me.
All right, ito naman, questions from Cyril Dan Castro of Abante tonight. Gaya daw ba ng ibang artista, nakakaranas ka rin daw po ba ng anxieties?
Of course. Of course. Yes. Lalo na nung nag-pandemic. Lalo na nung nagkaroon tayo ng lockdown and I wasn't able to work. I wasn't able to, ang daming projects na na-cancel, ang daming work na nawala. Of course, I had my own fair shares of anxieties and I couldn't say that I'm a master of managing it. Because, you know, we all need help once in a while. We all need someone to lean on once in a while and it's okay. Siguro it's more of lang talaga, I'm lucky that I have a strong support system. That I'm able to talk to people whom I trust. But yes, I do have my anxieties and I'm a very strong overthinker. So, but lately I'm learning how to manage it by being productive, by talking to people whom I trust. So I think we all have our own struggles and it's okay.
All right. And next question naman ni Roldan ay anong dream project mo na wish mong maibigay sa'yo ng Kapuso Network?
Dream project yun nga would be more action and a GL series.
All right. Paano mo naman daw madedescribe yung pag-aalaga sa'yo ng GMA?
They're very caring. They're very understanding. They don't just treat you as an artist. They treat you as family. Talagang they build the relationship with you not only through work but also through your personal life. They really make time to get to know you, to get to know your dreams, to get to know you, you as a person, as an artist. And very, very lucky. Very, very blessed and lucky to have a system like that in GMA Artist Center.
Okay. Ito naman, ano raw ang pinakamagandang nangyari sa'yo mula nang naging Kapuso actress ka?
Pinakamagandang nangyari sa akin mula naging Kapuso actress ako, yun nga, would be natupad ko lahat ng pangarap ko. GMA became an instrument for me to grow not only as an artist but as a person also. Almost half or more than half of my teenage years I spent with GMA and I learned a lot throughout that journey.
Okay, the next set of questions naman po ay from Ms. Salve Asis of Filipino Star ngayon. Aside daw from Khalil, sino pang Kapuso actor ang gusto mong makapartner in a project?
Aside from Khalil, grabe, no, hindi kasi talaga ako prepared sa listahan ko itong mga ganito. Really anybody talaga, any actor na ibigay or any partnership, I would just go for it. I'm game for it. And I'm happy that I'll be able to learn with that co-actor. But yeah, I'm game naman po with anyone.
Okay, ito naman from Tita Ian Ferrinos of People's Tonight. Sino pa raw ang gusto mong makatrabaho na Kapuso star naman, both senior and younger generation, and what's your reason behind it?
Both senior and younger. Sa senior, and I haven't worked with Kuya Dong kasi. I've worked with him in Encantadia but for a very, very short time. Like parang di ata pa kami nagka-eksena talaga. I really want to work with Kuya Dong because I admire how good of an actor he is. I admire his films. Napanood ko yung mga films niya. Sa ka-age ko naman, I haven't worked with Barbie in a series. I haven't worked with Julie in a series also and Kailin, and I really want to work with them kasi we're friends in AOS. So, hindi pa namin na-discover yung isa't isa sa serye. So, sana soon.
Alright, last set of questions naman po from Ray Sanchez of the Daily Tribune. You have a podcast called Figure It Out. And what are the things naman that you are still figuring out?
A lot. Every day I try to figure out things. Siguro more in a more specific angle. I'm still trying to figure out adulthood up to now. I'm in my early 20s and I feel like this is one of the most crucial stages of your life, yung adulting. And up to now, you know, dami ko pa rin discover. I'm still trying to figure out how to be like a full adult.
All right. And last na lang, what can your fans look forward to from this podcast?
Look forward to more relationship talks, more stories from Khalil and I, and just really being raw and authentic when it comes to figuring out life. Kasi kami ni Khalil are very vocal about our struggles, about our discoveries, about our stories. So yon, more on that in our podcast.
Okay, Gabbi, thank you for answering all the questions. If wala na po tayong mga tanong, we'd like to thank you all again for taking the time to join us this afternoon. Again, congratulations, Gabbi. Catch her this Saturday, 8:30 p.m. with Khalil Ramos and Manolo Pedrosa in Regal Studio Presents 1 Million Comments Magjojowa Na Ako on GMA 7. Before we officially wrap up, Gabbi, you can have your final message, and you will also take this time to promote your upcoming projects and ongoing projects. Yeah, go ahead.
Yes. First of all, I want to thank each and every one of you for all the years that you have been by my side, by GMA side. Thank you po sa lahat. Through ups and downs po, kayo po ang mga witness sa aking journey. That's why I really want to thank po each and every one of you. And also po, this coming Saturday, yung Regal Studio Presents 1 Million Comments Magjojowa Na Ako. Kasama ko po dyan si Khalil and si Manolo Pedrosa. That's 8:30 p.m. sa Sabado. Yun, sana po subaybayan po natin lahat. And also, you can watch me every Sunday on All Out Sundays, 12 noon. And also on IRL every Thursday sa GTV. And of course, this October, we will work on something. Kami ni Khalil, we are gonna work on a show called Stories from the Heart. I can't reveal pa kung anong klaseng episode, what kind of story, but definitely it will come last quarter of this year. And also, ang Love You Stranger, pinaka-inaabangan ko na Love You Stranger next year. I promise you all it will be worth it. And yun po. Thank you so much again for your time. And thank you to GMA and Artist Center for arranging this.
All right. Thank you, Gabbi. And thank you, everyone. Please stay safe. Bye po.
Thank you po.